So today we have, today is the last day of the summer school, so we really encourage you to do these notebooks that have been delivered to you. And today we want to, I think the first session will be quite interesting from Harry. He's going to talk about challenges and how you can participate in the challenges and how you can create groups and participate in and compete with other people. It's a good way to sharpen your skills. All right, so let's welcome Henry from University of Cali.
Hello, everyone. So my name is Henry Lalaina. Reputation is quite long. You can call me Henry. So I'm a PhD student at INRIA in University of Paris-Saclay. And this session is a joint work with Isabelle Guand, which is in, she's on the same team as me in Paris. I will talk, this session will be more on CODALAB and how to create challenge, how to participate in challenge on CODALAB. So I think that many of you don't know what is CODALAB. So the most important things about CODALAB is that it is a software, open source web-based platform that can enable researchers or data scientists to make a collaboration. So how this collaboration can be made, it's like Git or Jupyter Notebook. The idea is you centralizing the all the workflow of the data experiment on the cloud. So they store the code, the data, the environment, it means that the programming language, the software, all the libraries that are necessary to run the experiment, and the workflow. What I mean by workflow is how do you process your data? If you already work with machine learning experiment before, you see that you have your data, then you start by do some pre-processing, then you do some feature selection, then you create the machine learning model. But when you saw the score on the machine learning model, you maybe come back to add more pre-processing or add more feature selection. So this workflow is quite complex and it needs to be stored. And CODALAB is a good way to kind of store this history of processing in your experiment. So the main use of CODALAB in research is it's helped to ensure the reproducibility of research paper. I don't know how many of you have tried to reproduce paper from machine learning conference, and how many of you have succeeded with reproducing the same score as in the paper. Actually, it's not something that is obvious because there are many details that is not described in the papers. And CODALAB use this kind of environment that make all the workflow visible to all the researchers so that anyone can reproduce the paper with the same environment and the same data with the same code source. The second point is to use CODALAB is to create competition. There are many ways to create competition. For example, on Kaggle, you can create competition. Tomorrow, we will have a talk with Zendi, which is a platform that empowering competition in Africa. The main advantage of CODALAB is that it allows the participant to submit code and the prediction. So the main idea is that you run the competition, but you don't submit the prediction file or the results. You submit your code. So we can you can compare the code of participants. This talk, we mainly based on this how to create competition with some predefined constraint on the server. For example, we want to limit the the training time of a fixed number of minutes, the limit the memory of how many memory gigabytes you can use, and you want to make sure that each participant have the same environment that why do you need to create competition with code submission? The first one, the most important thing is that it makes fair comparison between the solution that provided by participant, because they are running the same machine on the same version of software and on the same constraint of hardware. The second one is that it makes more flexibility to the organizer to organize many kind of challenge, even not machine learning competition. For example, at the university in Paris Sud, we create a challenge to grade master student on. We create a competition for each course on algorithm, so that students required to write algorithm and submit their code on the platform, and the platform will test the algorithm itself, not the results. You can create a simple supervised machine learning that we will see today, but there are ways to create a more complex stuff like reinforcement learning, where the solution is delayed from a predefined time step. So this tutorial is divided in two parts. The first one is create a challenge. It's maybe interesting for those who are giving course in at the university. You want to encourage students to participate into your challenge. It does not have to be a machine learning challenge, as I said, but as long as it's writing code, you can always do it with Codalab. And the second one is to participate in the challenge. So because it's required a code submission, there is more predefined step that participant must follow in order to have their code running on the platform. So in this session, we will use the instance of Codalab at the LRE Paris. You can, as Codalab is open source, you can download Codalab, you can install it in your own machine. You can install it on your university or your lab, and you can create a challenge for students, whatever you like. So I won't spend many time to creating a challenge. For this challenge, we will use the use case that provided by Ernest and Dina, which is from the Macquarie University. So the idea is we have a kind of data set of microscopy image. And the goal is to detect parasites in the image. So you have one example of image, and the goal is to detect where is the location of the parasite on the image. So it's an object detection problem, but to simplify the task and just to simplify the task, we will cast it into a binary classification. So the idea is we have the same image, but we don't use the original image, but we do a patch extraction for 40 by 40, and by doing this, we have a lot of patch, and the idea is to classify whether a patch contains a parasite. This line is an example of patch that contains parasite, or it's not for the negative one. So the setup is actually the following: the input of the machine learning model is the patch of 40 by 40. The output will be binary, positive if the patch contains parasites, and zero otherwise. The evaluation metric will be the rock-hawk area under the curve of rock. Now we will start with how to create this challenge on CodeLab. So the fast way to create this challenge in 10 minutes is to start with a template. So the template, I will give the template on the materials. You can see, so these are the materials. You can see one creating challenge. So these are the required folder. So these are the required folder that necessary to create a challenge on CodeLab. So if you want to create your challenge at your own university, the easiest way to start is to start with this template and change the data, change the scoring function, change the how the workflow will go. So I will go through what the files are. The first one is the folder, which name is sample data. So in this folder, you have to put your data. For example, sample data is here. And in our case, we have the microscopy data from the Makerere University. We divide it into three, the train data, the solution for the train, and the same as validation and the test set. When it's done, the second one is you need to create a simple baseline solution that works on this data, because you require participants to write code. It means that you have to write a minimum solution that participant can start with. In our case, we have created a sample code is here. We have created a simple I don't know if you can see this, but we have created a simple convolutional CNN, simple CNN with only one layer of a CNN that works on the data, but does not give a good score. So this is given as a starting point for participants. It's for help students to start with the competition. The third one is the ingestion program. It's the main script that launch your competition. So actually, the script in this folder will read your data. It will apply the baseline to your data, and it will make prediction to this folder, to the sample result submission. So it's a simple Python. That reads data, apply the baseline that I described I have described, and store prediction to the sample result submission. The scoring program is the way to give you opportunity to define your metric. In our case, the metric is the area under the rock, the curve of rock, but you can choose your own metric. You can use accuracy or front score. As what you like. These remaining files is not necessary. These are optional, but it helps the participant to start with your challenge. Most of them are for instruction on how to start the challenge, some indication on what kind of challenge is this, to describe the rules of the challenge, and how to participate on the challenge. So these are not optional, but it will sure help students to start with your challenge. These two folders, you can remain it empty. It will be used by CodeLab. And the last one is the utilities, that it's the main script that generates your challenge on CodeLab. So if you if you go to the If I go to the material for the challenge, I go to the utilities folder. There are kind of three files. In order to create your challenge, you need to run the makebundle PI, and it will run your challenge as you described before. So it will start by reading your data. It's printing that it reads the data, send the training data, validation data, test data. Then it's train your baseline solution, which is a CNN. So the baseline solution is only trained on five epochs. So they run the five epochs. Then it makes the prediction, and when the prediction are done, it makes the it's calculate the score of your prediction on the available solution. And the other stuff is to zip and to add some files in order to make it work on CodaLab. So when you run it, there should be a new file, a zip file that you created, and you will so these are this file is the newly created bundle for your challenge. So in order to create your challenge on CodaLab, you have just to upload it. You must log in on the CodaLab server, and there is a link create competition. The internet connection is not working, but you have to upload this bundle on the website so that you can see the challenge that is created. So if everything is okay, you should have a challenge that is something like this. That it will have your challenge as you describe in the folder. The data that you put was accessible in the web page. The instruction you have wrote was put in the web page, and the rules and the terms of condition are all included in the web page of the lab. So this is the first part on how it's a very fast kind of tutorial on how to create challenge. I don't know if there is question on which steps is if you have an issue. Yes. Actually, for the data, you can use what format you like, but you in the ingestion program you need to adapt the program that read your data on the following format. So in our case, we use an AutoML format, and we have an ingestion program that read the specified format, but you can leave it as images, but then you need to adapt your ingestion program to read the images from the data. Yes.
So if you wanted to modify the challenge, would you have to do the files again locally and upload them all, the zip again?
Actually, there is a way to modify challenge when you are organizer of the challenge on the CodaLab. When you submit the challenge on CodaLab, you have the challenge created, and there is some link here that can do some administration of the challenge. You can edit the challenge, you can extend the deadline, you can add more data, you can change the data, you can change the rules. So there is a way for you don't have to re-upload it in order to change the data.
So whenever you create a new challenge, you must adapt to the format that you have on the ingestion program?
So this is a template. If your challenge is about comparing algorithms, I think there is no data, and you have to adapt it, but the ingestion program, we just run the algorithms and they check how the times that it takes to launch. But then it's up to you on what you like to do on CodeLab. The most important thing is that here is the ingestion program on how CodeLab will run the challenge, and the scoring program, how they score the submission. Because this submission can be the training time or the performance or whatever. So these are the two key points that you need to specify if you want to create your own challenge.
So this is a code submission challenge?
Yes. So this is a code submission challenge.
Oh, okay. So if you are just doing a challenge rather than submitting a file, that change?
Actually, by default, CodeLab allow you to submit the prediction files, the code submission, and the trained model. You can train your model locally, then you submit the trained model. So CodeLab will not test it. We will not train it anymore. So these are the three possibilities that by default work with CodeLab. But then you can specify if you do not want participants to submit code, or you want them to just submit prediction files, you can modify it on the website. Yes?
For example, just if I create a look at this challenge, and I was my problem, like, from case of questions, so how can the adjustment come?
Sorry?
Yes. Adjustment, like, for example, if I create my own challenge, local servers, so I can create my own problems, is that possible to create my own problem?
Yes. So it's a software, you can install it on your machine and you can run your challenge on your machine and you can participate on your machine. Maybe it's time now to go to the second part, which is more interesting for the students. So this way, we have just created a challenge on microscopy data, and we want a student to work with it. so the materials are already on the files. So the material for participant challenge is on the two participants. You have to unzip the starting kit because you have to unzip the starting kit. Then when you have the starting kit, you can see that you have the same structure of the way we defined the challenge earlier. So to participate on the challenge, all you need to do is to modify the sample code submission / model.pi. So this is the files you are required to modify. So there are three points that you can modify. So you can choose how your network will be. You can add more layers. You can change the parameters of the current baseline. On the fit and the predict method, you can add some pre-processing step before doing the training or before doing the prediction. So we have created a notebook in order to test your model PI before submitting in the CodeLab. So you have to run your notebook. Then, no, that's not here. And the main notebook is the README IPython notebook. So this notebook will help you to do a submission on CodaLab. So there are the defined steps that required to kind of read the data from the folder, to have some example of visualization on the possible possible data. You can add more visualization if you want to improve over your model. Then there are cells that will launch your model on locally. So when you run these cells, it will run the code defined in the sample code submission model.py. So all you need to do is to modify these files and test it with the notebook if everything is okay. For example, here we can test the current solution on the notebook. So it's training on the simple convolutional layer on 5 epochs. So you can see your scores locally. You can improve it. You can improve it by changing some hyperparameters here, and then rerun the code to see how it looks like. Now that the training is finished, then there is a way to see the score on the validation set and the score on the training set that you have locally. So you can all you need to do is to is to change the model.py in order to improve over this score. When you are okay with your model, you can create a submission with the last cell of CodaLab. You run it. It will create two zip files that are that are here, and you create a sample commission.zip. You upload it on the challenge. You go to the website of the challenge, you go to the site where you can upload it, and then you upload it here. And then you can see your score on the leaderboard of CodaLab. So now it's time for you to get into the, create your own model. So defined rule for this challenge is that the training time is limited to 5 minutes for each submission. You are allowed to do 5 submissions maximum for the days. And the tentative deadline is today at 4 p.m., but I think it will be extended for Friday. So I really recommend you to work as a team so that you can test many models in parallel. So you just need to submit one model for each team. So let's say we'll give us 25 minutes for kind of practicing it on locally on Jupyter notebook. If you have your internet working, you can submit on CodaLab. But if you do not have internet connection, you just practice locally and check a better model that you can submit at home this afternoon. So the link of the competition is here. And to make a submission is you just have follow the Jupyter notebook to create the zip file, or you can directly zip the model.py and the metadata files into a single zip file and upload it onto the CodaLab. So we will give 20 minutes for for kind of fans on Jupyter Notebook.